When developing complex workflows, finding mistakes is pretty difficult. UiPath Studio comes with a debug component that helps you find problems more easily. This is useful for viewing the execution of each activity to verify what data it gets and in checking if there are errors in producing outputs. UiPath is a real-time engine that checks for errors while you are working with your workflow. Whenever an activity has errors, UiPath Workflow Designer notifies you and gives you details about the issue encountered. Also, it will not allow you to run a workflow if you have an existing notification error. In our sample workflow, we have this red dot with exclamation point. This lets you know that somewhere in a workflow an activity has an error. Hovering over it will provide you a message about the error. In this case, it gives an error, one or more children have validation errors or warning. This means that one of the activities inside this container generates the error. To quickly find the source activity, you can go to the outline panel and click the red dot. This will show the activities with errors or warnings. So, the activity that generates the error is the message box activity, which is highlighted in a red box. There are two possible reasons why we could get this error. First, the variable used isn't declared or not present in the variables panel. Second, if it is declared, it is not available in the sequence, meaning the activity doesn't have access to the scope of the variable. Let's double-click the message box to open it. First, let's check if the variable is declared. Let's go to the variables panel. As you can see, the variable result1 is not declared. We have the variable result, but what we've used is result1. This is why the activity is giving an error. Next thing we need to check is the scope of the variable. In this case, it was set to main, so that means we can use this variable anywhere in our workflow. Let's correct the error and change it to a proper name. As you can see, the notification error disappeared. Next, let's debug our workflow. When running our workflow in debug mode, we have three execution speeds: slow, normal, and fast. These specify how fast you want each activity to be executed. Let's select slow. We can also run the workflow step by step using the next button. This allows us to carefully inspect each activity during the execution. It runs from the outside container into more specific ones, from top to bottom. Let's click it to see how it works. There, it started from the main, to the recorded sequence, and went to each of the activities starting from the top. Let's stop for now. You can stop debugging anytime using the stop button, and it gives you this message box. That's okay. Next, you can pause the workflow's execution while debugging by setting up breakpoints. We'll just need to click the activity where we wanted to stop and press the toggle breakpoint button. You can also press Ctrl F9 as a shortcut. During debugging, you can check the real-time logging of the activities in the output panel. Let's put this back to normal. Let's start debugging by clicking the Start Debug and see how it works. Execution stops each time it encounters a breakpoint. This is very useful when you create a complex or long workflow. So instead of running the entire workflow, you can set a breakpoint to where you wanted it to stop. We can continue to debug by pressing the continue button or by pressing F6. Debugging is handy when you receive runtime errors. There are errors that don't appear during workflow design. They appear when you are executing the workflow. If you have a big workflow, debugging is the quickest way of finding the activity that generates the error. Let's find close application and drag it here all the way to the bottom. Then let's specify the application we wanted to close. That will be our calculator app. This should work. Let's remove the breakpoints and run the debug and see what happens. So yes, it works. Let's go back to the close application activity. This activity will execute successfully only if the selector will successfully identify the calculator app. Now, let's try to move it inside the attach window container. Let me go back to the output panel and let's debug once again. Now, the workflow gives the following error message. We don't have the notification error in our workflow designer, but an error still exists and is shown only after running the workflow. So the best thing we can do is to find out what is this error about. Let's close this error message and the calculator. Then let's go to the output panel. In our output panel, we get an error after executing the close application activity, and we get invalid UI node. That means our activity cannot correctly identify the calculator application while placed inside a container and having the current selector. Here's the reason why. When we place something inside a container, UiPath tries to identify first the container and then the element or activity inside it. But when we click copy, the menu window has vanished. UiPath tries to find it first and only then it moves to what is placed in a container. So how do we fix it? We need to move this sequence from a container that doesn't exist anymore. Well, let's also move the message box here. So it closes the calculator app first and afterwards displays the message. Okay, let's debug again. Cool! So there, our workflow is running correctly and in our output panel, all activities has been executed successfully. Now that you know the basics of debugging your workflow, in the next video, we will learn how to run specific automation based on user inputs. Stay tuned!